The summer wind came blowing in from across the sea.
Take the show with Daryl.
It lingered there.
Nice, nice.
To touch your
and
head.
He still is a great guy in spite of that. And is a real pro at everything real estate. I know he likes to help people with whatever they want to do in real estate and, you know, and give all of his opinions and get the opinions of others and make sure that everybody knows what's going on, whether they're in a real estate transaction, thinking of one, or even if they haven't thought of one, at least Jim might make allow for that to begin to think. So with that, let me let Jim introduce himself, and then we'll get right back to it.
Well, thanks a lot, Jay. My name is Jim Carven. I'm a broker associate at TNG Real Estate in Fullerton. My DRE license number is 01437693, so I can get that out of the way without forgetting, getting in trouble there. I have been in real estate for 18 years. I enjoy helping people do whatever it is they want to do with real estate. And I work primarily with friends and referrals and customer referrals. And getting a little older, I'm semi-retired, but I can't seem to resist still doing deals. And a lot of them are actually related to retirement now, because a lot of my friends are retiring and moving out of state here and there and moving their money around. So
Well, you may be getting older, but if the audience wants to see what old looks like, take a look at this side of the screen. This is old. Jim is just getting there. Okay, so we'll be clear on that. So I know that you love working with all people, but this show and a lot of it has to do with retirement and, you know, the semi-retired. I personally think that I'll work forever, no matter what the financial situation is. But, you know, what kind of questions do you actually get from retirement age people that you've been working with? You know, either on their primary residence or other things like that.
It depends on, you know, what they're actually doing. If they're selling to move out of state, and that's their primary residence, they're, you know, asking if I can direct them to, you know, a realtor in the place where they're starting to move to, or, of course, we need to first make sure they get as much as they can for their property in this market, which is hasn't been very difficult because it's been a really hot market. I do work with younger people. I just closed a couple of deals for a condo in Hollywood that was an up and coming talent scout at Warner Brothers Records.
Wow.
And his friend, his good time friend, is actually the VP at Warner, and I just helped him and one of his friends go in together on a cabin in Big Bear, which was really a lot of fun. I spent a lot of time up in that area doing four wheeling. I was an off-road buff for 48 years.
Wow.
Used to be in Jeep clubs, two at once, founded one of them. So it's always fun to go up there and work with recreational property. So, and that's sort of getting to their retirement. They want to get a number of Airbnb rentals, and that's their first one. So they can probably rent that out for two solid Airbnb months and pay the entire year's worth of mortgage payments.
Wow. More people need to think about that, don't they?
Yes. Yes. That is something to think about. If you have some extra money and you want to put it someplace besides in the bank.
Uh-huh. Well, the bank is returning such high dividends now, right?
It's disgusting.
That was a joke. Yeah.
I know.
And of course, we do know some ways for people to get some extra cash for those things, but we're not going to talk about what I do. We're going to talk about what you do this time around. And so that's a great idea, though, to get that. And when you can mix business and pleasure, like going to those areas that you really love, I bet that's a good time for you, right?
It is really a great time for me to go up there and do what I have to do and take some extra time to go around and visit some of the things that there are. I plan on seeing the Alpine Zoo next time I'm up there.
Right, right. I remember Daryl had the curator of that on, and I talked about that on the show here once about what to do on weekends and things like that. So, yeah, that's great. I got to get up there and do that, too. But, exactly. You know, some people are selling their home for tax and estate planning and opportunities like that. Do you come across things of that nature?
I do. More and more people I know and referrals, they're selling their place either to move or perhaps they have rentals and they want to use the money for something else. They're tired being a landlord. I just sold a six-unit apartment in Van Nuys that started with a deal a few years ago. I sold a shopping center for a couple, and they in El Monte, a 22-unit shopping center in El Monte, and then we 1031 exchanged it into this 2012 apartment in Van Nuys. It was really a nice, fairly new apartment building, and they held on to that long enough to turn it into a pretty good investment. And then they just sold that. I just closed that last Friday, and they're taking that money and going
to you and to them. Yeah.
Yes. And they're going to take that money and they're moving up to Washington State. So,
yeah.
It's a matter of moving money around and seeing what they're going to do, you know, thinking about their retirements.
Yeah, a lot of people are moving out of state. You find some of that happening with some of the sales that you're doing, right?
Yes, absolutely. Some are. People I know have moved to Idaho, Arizona, Texas.
All those areas have a little more room than we do here. Well, we have a lot of empty space here in California, but not all of it is desirable to live in, like in the middle of the desert or this or that, or you and I would probably love to be in the mountaintop, but not everybody. But that's what states, so I think you mentioned some states. Are those the ones that you find are most popular these days?
Those in Florida. Those four states seem to be the most popular ones that people are going to.
Well, Florida definitely has warm weather. A lot more humid than here, though. I'm not sure how much I would like that.
They've got some giant lizards.
Yeah, oh boy. And I hear the bugs are as big as Volkswagens, but I'm not sure about that.
No.
But no.
But no, I don't know. I think maybe the mosquito might be the state bird in Florida.
Oh, perfect. But yeah, and of course, a lot of people come from the north, the northeast, and go down there. That seems to be the pathway down there instead of over to California. Mm-hmm. But you know, I still love California. But you know, Washington and Oregon seem awfully inviting to me, amongst other places. Like you know, I'd love to have a place to go to, like you said, at Airbnb, like maybe Taos, New Mexico, Sedona area up there around, whatever. Anyway, that's just me dreaming. So I'm sure you put up with a lot of people dreaming also.
I love it when people dream. I really do. It's nice to share in that. And, you know, it's out of necessity a lot of times because people are getting ready to retire and they still haven't paid off their mortgage. Mm-hmm. And, you know, they may think about selling, cashing out their property in California and using the equity to pay cash for a nice property in a lesser expensive state and have money left over. And that way the mortgage, you know, is gone. Or they may be thinking about, you know, the reverse mortgage route so they can stay in sunny Southern California, which I've lived here my whole life. It's really hard to beat. you know, Southern California. I'm where I live in Anaheim Hills. It's about an hour away from the mountains, the desert, and the beach. So if you like all those nature places, you just can't beat it.
No, you cannot. And you listen to people's dreams and you help change those dreams into reality. So you are the dream to reality changer.
Love to be.
Yeah. And that's great. But a couple other quick things just to think about with the older set. You find a lot of people are selling their homes or other properties to transfer profits into retirement savings or investments in a more appropriate size home that's easier to manage.
Yeah, downsizing is big because, you know, once, you know, you become an empty nester and you got a 4-5 bedroom house and, you know, it's a bit much to keep care of the whole time and you're tired cutting the grass or hiring gardeners and you want to move into a condo, you know, you might want to downsize and also maybe get rid of your mortgage payment.
Yeah, you can do that with a reverse mortgage purchase and still have a lot of money left over. But like I said, it's not it. Go ahead.
No, and on top of that, they can use Proposition 60 to keep their old property tax base.
Wow. And do you want to talk a little bit about that? It's really important.
It is, especially if you bought your house a long, long time ago for a lot less money than it's worth now. You know from looking at your tax assessor statements every year that they're assessing your property at much, much less than it's worth because Prop 13 has shielded you from your property taxes increasing exponentially the way the real estate values have. And if you were to downsize, it wouldn't really help you that much if you had to still, you know, if you had to pay a giant tax that related to what the new value is. And so keeping your old tax base is really the best thing to do, and it can be done. They should talk to their CPA and also just begin by looking up Proposition 60 online and get a real good explanation of what that's all about. But definitely, it's not something that you should overlook.
No, not at all. And, you know, along those same lines, retirement age people sometimes that have owned rental properties, I think you already mentioned that, you know, maybe they want to get out of being a landlord and finding something else to do, like, you know, selling their investment properties for other things. But you did mention 1031 exchanges. And I think before you talk about that, because that's so important, why don't you give out your contact information, everything about how people can get a hold of you to get this really great information.
Okay. Again, my name is Jim Carven. My website is jimcarven.com, JIMCARVIN.com. I can be reached by phone at 714-925-1599. And incidentally, my 1031 website where you can learn about that is 1031answers.com.
Wow, 1031 answers. Great. Because I'm sure there's a lot more questions than we're going to get answered here in this limited time. But go ahead and give us a little overall on the 1031.
A 1031 exchange, just to define it, and I'm going to use simple terms so people won't gloss over on their drives home, but a 1031 exchange allows you not to get taxed, at least to defer the tax on your sale of your existing rental property so that you have all that money as much as possible to put into your next investment property. It doesn't help for your primary residence. It's strictly an IRS tax code that applies to rental properties or business properties. And, it's really the only way you can you should ever buy and sell or sell and buy rentals. And there are some restrictions that go along with it. For example, you have to identify, they do kind of make it tough for you, but they want to make sure it moves along. So, you know, you have to identify, you know, three properties. In the most simple scenario, you identify three properties. You have to close on one of those specific properties that you've identified within 45 days of selling the one that you had. And it's not impossible, but it's most of the time it works just fine. I've never had a time where I failed at doing that.
Good.
The idea is to get started as soon as you can.
Right.
Planning ahead for it and not decide you want to do it, you know, while you're, you know, after you've sold, and maybe you need a 45-day escrow and you don't even have 45 days left.
Right, right. And the money that you got from the sale of the first property, the one you're moving, or the one that you're selling, that those funds are not available for you to spend, are they?
No, they aren't. It has to be all set up ahead of time. And what makes it an exchange, a 1031 exchange, is that you never actually take possession of the money. We use a service which is required called a qualified intermediary. The old term used to be an accommodator, who actually gets the money directly from escrow, so you never get your sweating palms on it. And then they hold on to it, and when you buy your next property, they put it into the escrow for your new property. And the new property can be worth more. And yes, it can be worth less than your old property, which seems to be news to a lot of people.
Yeah, to me.
And the only thing is, if you do take money out, you will get taxed on the money that you take out. But it doesn't blow the deal. It's not an all or nothing thing.
Oh, that's good. That's good to know. So if there is money left over, you get it, and that's the amount you pay the taxes on, not the entire amount of the sale.
Exactly.
So that
does not disqualify the sale at all.
So that means you get to save a whole lot of tax money. I mean, a whole lot.
Could be a ton of money.
Yeah, not to mention a lot, too. And, So well, I'm sure what you're doing allows for a lot of estate planning also, correct?
It does. And, you know, you being in the financial business for a long time.
Forever, for 200-300 years. But yeah, I don't know that I learned much, but I like to think so. But yeah.
Well, you can't avoid it. If you pay attention, you learn something new every day, right?
You got to do it. That is so right.
And the more you know, the more ignorant you feel. So it just kind of works out. But
that is so true. That's absolutely true.
So you probably run across a lot of people who don't have, they never even talked to an estate planner and they're ready to retire.
That's correct.
A little disappointing.
But I think more and more are starting to focus on that as they're getting older. Unfortunately, my generation, I think I was the first baby boomer to be born in 1946. It just wasn't part of our financial planning. I mean, it has to be. And, you know, healthcare, things like that, they have to be part of financial planning. And I think more and more people now are starting to look for people that they can, can have these discussions with.
Exactly. I remember I grew up in the 50s and 60s, and back then, somebody who was 30 was might as well give up, right?
Absolutely. We were so old. Oh, and look at me now. No, don't look at me. But, you know, you don't just deal with older people. There's a lot of younger people, or we call them younger seniors, but whatever.
Oh, yes.
They don't need a lot of income now, but, you know, they need to be set up for later in life.
Well, yes. And even like my personal friends who are older now they have kids, and I help them buy properties. And it's always good to find someone who's, you know, it was such a privilege to be able to help somebody get their first home. There was one young couple, they're newlyweds, and they kept looking for a new home. Of course, they didn't have hardly any savings, hardly any down payment. They only qualified for $400,000, which in this market in Southern California, there's nothing virtually that you could get where you would want to live for $400,000.
Right.
And if they bid on a house that was $400,000 by the time it sold, yeah, people had bid it up to $450,000, and I wound up helping them get a brand new condo in Rialto for $392,000. It was the second.
Wow.
It was the last one in the phase. And there was two the day before when I found it from driving all around out there. And I said, I got him on the phone. I said, I found a beautiful brand new condo, 2-bed, 2.5-bath, all brand new. You're going to love it. You got to get out here tomorrow and you got to sign something. There's two left. And when they got out there, there was one left and they got it. So
you know,
it was
Rialto's
just wonderful.
That, all that far. And if you're doing it the right way, I mean, my wife and I had lunch with some past clients, which are now friends in Rialto. Where was it? Cucas, Mexican food on Riverside. And, you know, it didn't take us very long at all. The traffic was going the other way, which is nice. But, you know, we do have a Metrolink, which goes right through there and things like that if you're working in almost anywhere else. So,
absolutely. Well, the wife works at Amazon right off 15, so that's pretty close.
That's a little bitty company with about, well, you know,
about a half a mile long warehouse.
I was going to say more like a mile, but I think you're probably more correct. Yeah, I know. It's crazy. And a lot of that has to do with the airport being near there, too, with the free trade kind of thing. But Daryl knows a lot more about airports, as you know, from his show.
Yeah,
but, you know, and as these people get older, healthcare is such a, that's another thing that when we were younger, we never put that into our financial plan, healthcare. It was so far off and we never thought about it. And boy, I wish we had. And now they're beginning to have more. Well, the light's kind of coming on a little bit earlier in life, so they need that kind of thing. And, you know, what's the best investment really overall? Well, there's a lot of these other things we've been kind of hinting at and talking about, but real estate is still number one, right?
It's number one, and if you want to put money into something safe, that's where it can be. It provides protection against inflation, because cheaper dollars, it takes more to buy something real. And just real quickly, one thing that a lot of people haven't heard about is the Delaware Statutory Trust.
Right, right. I heard about it from you, but that's it. So go ahead, please.
Okay. Just as a case study, there's a person who I refer to as a terminal landlady. She's had rentals in Anaheim Hills since they were built.
Wow.
And, you know, got them for double, you know, five digits. And if she sold them, she would be taxed to the hilt. And so she's with the Delaware Statutory Trust, or DST, she's able to do a 1031 exchange into a 1031 eligible DST, which is real estate. And it's like putting your money into a fund, and she's able to get a much higher return on her money than she has been getting from renting them out.
Wow. So there's a whole lot more to that. And
there's,
we need to have you back to discuss that, because our time right now is up.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Of course, you can come back after the hour and talk a little more about it, but I'd love to have you back on again, because that's just an amazing feature.
Absolutely.
And we probably have only about 30 seconds left. I want to use that. Oh, we have actually a whole minute. So go ahead, Jim, and please give out all of your contact information again. And you know, we've tickled them about that Delaware thing, so you know they'll be wanting to know the rest, and they can find the rest by calling you, right?
They can find the rest by calling me at 714-925-1599. And just so you don't have to crash while you're driving trying to write that down, if you just go to 1031answers.com, 1031answers.com, there's a real good Q&A session in there, and all my contact is in there.
You know, you've got a great voice, and, you know, people say, you know, there's that joke, I have a face for radio, but you've got a great voice for radio. You should get your own show here on KMET. But we can talk about that another time. So, you know, if they're open, get away with it, anybody's doing it. Well, I'm not
through nights that never end. My fickle friend, the summer wind. The summer wind. Warm summer wind. The summer wind.